Hey there, health nuts! The internet can be packed with information about your health, but the truth is, you need to be careful what you're reading. What's more alarming? Medical myths that existed long before the internet. Let's talk about them. Does sitting close to the TV really hurt your eyes? Does cold weather really make you sick? How about chewing gum? Does it really stay in your system for 7 years? We're talking all that and more. Let's begin. Number 1. Chewing gum stays in your system for years. We're kicking things off with something you've probably been hearing since childhood. Don't chew that gum or it'll be inside you forever. Although it's not meant to be swallowed, chewing gum really isn't that harmful if it is. The great myth used to be that it will stay in your system for 7 years. We're here to say that this is not true. While your body can't digest gum the way it does other food, have no fear. This doesn't mean it's destined to stay in your body for the rest of your life. Here's where it does become a problem. If you swallow a large piece of gum or several small pieces of gum in the same period of time, it may block your digestive tract. But if you happen to swallow a piece every once in a while, it shouldn't be an issue. Basically, what happens is that your body will absorb the sugar from the gum, but the resin within the gum remains in the body until it passes through the digestive tract and leaves you in the bathroom. Regardless of whether or not it will stay in your system, you should probably refrain from swallowing your chewing gum too often. Number 2. Sitting too close to the TV ruins your eyesight. Another irritating lecture you got from your parents growing up was to never sit too close to the television, as it could permanently hurt your sight. This belief has a specific origin. In the 1950s, TV would emit a light from intense ray tubes. A common belief was that the radiation from this light may ruin people's eyesight, with children being especially vulnerable. While that may have been true then, our technology has advanced. The truth is that it's more likely to cause eye strain. This is when your eyes get tired from focusing on one particular object or image. Since children are able to focus their eyes on something for a longer period than adults, they are much less likely to develop eye strain. This is why you may see them sitting closer to the television or holding their phone screens only inches from their face. As we get older, our eyes tend to become exhausted much quicker. So if a grown-up person such as yourself is sitting too close to a screen, it won't take long until you decide to move back. Just find the distance that you personally feel comfortable with and relax. Number 3. Cold weather will make you sick. One of the main precautions we take during the winter time is to bundle up so we don't get sick. Is it really any wonder? Cold and flu warnings do double during this season. While some viruses, such as rhinovirus, spread in cold temperatures, it is the germs that make you sick, not the cold weather itself. Certain viruses replicate better in cold temperatures. This allows germs to thrive and spread. At the same time, research has suggested that during the winter, your immune system will employ the help of antiviral defense to stop the cold from infecting you. But this works better at lung temperature rather than nasal temperature. If the temperature in your nose and upper airway is lowered by cold temperatures, your body's defense may not work. On the topic of cold weather, other studies have suggested that influenza can spread just as easily in humid temperatures as it does in cold. Number 4. Your heart stops when you sneeze. Let's just get this out of the way. Your heart does not stop when you sneeze. Medical experts state that it simply gets thrown off its rhythm, very briefly, mind you. You may notice that before you sneeze, you quickly inhale. This slows down your blood pressure. When the sneeze finally comes out, your heartbeat is briefly interrupted, which gives your blood pressure time to increase. Your vagus nerve also plays a massive role in this interruption. When the vagus nerve is stimulated by your sneeze, it lowers the heart rate. This throws the heart off of its rhythm, only to get back on track when your blood pressure is back to normal. Number 5. Weight loss tea flushes toxins out of your body. Weight loss tea is all the rage among many in the fitness community. Certain teas are believed to cleanse the body of toxins. But the truth is, our bodies naturally do this for us. While you may believe the tea you're purchasing is aiding your digestion, flattening your stomach, and boosting your metabolism, little evidence exists to support this. Many of these products actually contain ingredients that are harmful to our bodies. Several lawsuits have also been filed against different tea companies for false advertising. Here's what slimming tea can do. Many of them actually contain a laxative known as senna. People who drink senna teas often run into issues such as diarrhea, nausea, and cramps. So while it may not have the effects it claims to have, slimming tea can cause you to lose weight while dehydrating you. Keep in mind that some animal studies have shown that the polyphenols in green tea can help your metabolism and assist in weight loss. Are you enjoying this list so far? This next one is sure to catch you off guard. But before we continue, are you concerned about the overall state of your health? Perhaps you'd like our recent video on 7 healthy benefits of fish oil. Also, if you're looking for that special somebody, check out our video listing 16 reasons why you should date a Scorpio. Now let's continue our list on common medical myths. Number 6, artificial sweetener leads to cancer. This is one of the myths that you may not have read about. The medical community has believed for quite some time that artificial sweeteners can cause cancer. These are substitutes for sugar, such as the ones found in diet soda. But like many of these claims, there is no proper evidence that links the sweeteners and cancers together. Early studies from the 1970s suggest that saccharin from sugar substitutes caused bladder cancer in animals, but there's no clear association with cancer in humans. Various experiments done with aspartame have also cleared it as a cancer-causing agent. Years ago, scientists believed that the substitute could cause tumors in rats, but after numerous studies, this was debunked. Since there's no clear evidence pointing towards artificial sweeteners causing cancer, many in the health community have become concerned when soda drinkers ditch diet soda out of fear of illness. This generally leads them to resort to regular soda, leaving them vulnerable to possible heart disease and diabetes in the long term. Number 7. Hand sanitizer is the best way to clean your hands. We all know that one person who carries the bottle of hand sanitizer with them everywhere they go. Those with this habit tend to depend more on the sanitizer to clean their hands than their kitchen faucet. It is highly recommended by health officials that if you want to clean your hands properly, you wash them with soap and water. This reduces the amount of chemicals and germs on the hands. Hand sanitizers are said to not eliminate all germs. Studies have shown that hand sanitizers are best in places like hospitals. If you're outside in a public area such as the mall, restaurant, or the city bus, your hands can come in contact with many different germs very quickly. This soils your hands a little too heavily, making hand sanitizer less effective. They may also not be as potent against pesticides and metals. So if it's available, try using regular soap and water to clean your hands. Number 8. Vaccines cause autism. This is bound to be our most controversial pick for this list, but it must be said loud for all to hear. While the debate has raged on for quite some time, vaccines are not linked to autism. Many parents have come to fear that vaccines given to their kids may lead them to develop autism spectrum disorder later in life, but various studies have concluded that the two have no association. Nevertheless, this rumor has lent itself to the unnecessary stigma against those on the spectrum. One study conducted in 2013 focused on antigens in vaccines received by children before the age of 2. Antigens are the substances in vaccines that cause the body's immune system to produce antibodies. By the end of the study, the number of antigens between children with autism and children without were the exact same. Were you aware of any of these myths? Did you find this video helpful? Let us know in the comments below. We would love to hear from you. Enjoyed this video? Hit like, share, and subscribe to Bestie. Wait, what kind of bestie are we if we don't tell you about our other awesome videos? Go ahead, choose the left or right video and enjoy.